Heisman hopeful Kellen Moore and the third-ranked Boise State Broncos ride into Laramie, Wyoming tonight with a 15-game winning streak in their back pocket. But Cowboy fans have arrived in full force and hope to spoil that run of wins and dreams of a national championship. Since 2000, Boise State has made 9 bowl appearances while claiming more wins and averaging more points than any other team in the nation. Entering 2010 with their highest preseason ranking ever, the boys in blue came ready to play in week one versus 10th-ranked Virginia Tech.
Nice snap. Saunders will kick it. It's blocked. Harper bouncing to the outside. Breaks free. 20, 10, 5. Broncos lead. Moore throwing the ball. Back of the end zone. Pettis has a touchdown. Bronco Nation, get ready to celebrate.
Their quest for a national title bid continues tonight in Wyoming. Next on the CBS College Sports Network. National power Boise State battles Wyoming, and a sellout crowd awaits the hometown Cowboys. And the third-ranked Broncos of Boise State. Craig Bowler Jack along with Aaron Taylor, so glad you're with us. And let's talk about Chris Peterson. After he took over Boise State now 5 years ago, this ball club is 50-4. Forget about the Cinderella title. This is a BCS powerhouse program.
There's no question, Craig. A one-hit wonder, they are not. Boise State has taken on and beaten the big boys. In fact, they are 5-1 in their last 6 games against BCS opponents. That includes 2 Fiesta Bowl victories over Oklahoma and TCU. When you watch Boise State play, you'll be impressed by their big and physical offensive lines, the tremendous explosiveness that they have at the skill position, and the quarterback, Kellen Moore. No good program can do it without a good quarterback, and Kellen Moore is one of the best in the country. The record of 27-1 says all you need to know about this young man. He's tremendous. He's a great decision maker. He's calm under pressure, and he does whatever it takes to be able to find a way to win. And that last drive against Virginia Tech, he looked cool as a cucumber. He made Joe Montana look like a nervous Nelly.
Oh, boy, those are big words. Let's talk about Wyoming. And, of course, since Dave Christensen took over this program, they've done some fine things in a very short period of time. Last year, Aaron, they go 7-6. They win a bowl game for the first time since 1987 under Paul Roach. And what Wyoming is trying to do is basically copy Boise State's program.
Yeah, there's no question they would be wise to do that. And to be able to do that, you have to be able to recruit and develop talent. And one of those players is Austin Carter Samuels, Mountain West Conference Freshman of the Year. You also, to build a program, have to be able to get the team to believe in themselves. You've got to change the culture. And 7-6 last year with a bowl victory is a mighty fine start.
You know, Aaron's tragedy struck this Wyoming campus back on September 6th. Freshman linebacker was taken from Wyoming, Ruben Narcisse, in a car accident the early morning of September 6th. And this is Wyoming's first home game since that tragic day. And for more, let's take you downstairs and check in with Brooke Olsendam. Brooke?
Even though he was just a freshman, Craig, spent only 3 months here on campus, Ruben made quite an impression here in Laramie. The entire football team made their cowboy walk from their hotel to the stadium wearing shirts with his number 12 on the front and on the back, Ruben Narcisse, always a cowboy. And students are paying tribute today as well. 5,000 of the same shirts handed out before today's game. His teammates honoring him on the field as well by wearing his jersey. Last week, Shamil Gary wore it against Texas. This week, Captain Brian Hendricks asked to wear number 12. He told me it's a way to support each other and remember Ruben.
All right, thank you, Brooke. And we are underway as tonight's college football game on CBS is brought to you in crystal clear high definition. The Cowboys and the Broncos anxious to get this one going. Aaron, we'll keep an eye on Boise State tonight. They have not played in 12 days. It's almost like restarting a season.
Yeah, we saw what happened with Virginia Tech when they had to play 5 days after, but Chris Peterson said he didn't know if his team was any better off playing 12 days because you get a little rusty. But taking a look at the quarterback for Wyoming, Austin Carter Samuels, he's a team leader. He's very mobile and he's tough. The coaches want him to slide head first, but he's not that type of player. He is key to this offense being successful tonight.
Wyoming with the football to start this game on their home field. Play action pass. And pressure comes, and down goes the quarterback, and a final one in Austin Carter Samuels. Baker coming strong with the pressure, and let's take a look now at our Geico difference makers.
Well, on the offensive side, he's physical and he's also a threat on special teams, and he's complimented by Zach Bolger. Does a good job offensively and had a huge game last week against Texas.
Pitch and catch near side, big gainer up to the 25-yard line. And Wyoming moves the football with Zach Bolger. And difference makers on the defensive side.
Yeah, Boise's got one or two of those. Ryan Winterswijk gets after the quarterback and has a great motor, 9 sacks last year. And at the nickel position, Winston Venable, he's a ball hawk who had a key interception versus TCU in the Fiesta Bowl. He's got to show up big tonight to stop this offense.
Third down and 5 for Carter Samuels. From the shotgun formation, first drive of this series tonight. Good protection, stands in the pocket, floats it up high. Oh, had it and dropped. Robert Huron, first down and then some, but could not grab the handle.
Carter Samuels had plenty of time, does a great job of beating the cornerback, but unfortunately cannot hold on to the football. That's a costly mistake here early for this Wyoming offense that desperately needed to start with some momentum.
And the punt is away by McCoy. And a fair catch called for, and a good bounce for Wyoming. Touched, and they will down that football around the 26-yard line. So we'll get our first one tonight. Kellen Moore, the Heisman hopeful, and we'll take a look at our quarterback profile brought to you by 5-Hour Energy.
Well, Kellen Moore does a great job of protecting the football, only 3 interceptions last year. He does a good job of placing the football. Only his receivers can get it, as we saw against Virginia Tech. And the man is ice cold. He really is calm, cool, collected under pressure. So Wyoming needs to pick their poison. If they go after him, Kellen Moore can make you pay.
3 wide receivers sent. The lone back is Doug Martin. He'll mark the ball first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Kellen Moore on play action. He's a left-hander, throws a dart complete near midfield, still on his feet. And that is big yardage for Austin Pettis. So Pettis moves the chains to midfield as we look at our Geico difference makers.
Well, you can't talk about Boise State without Austin Pettis. Had a huge game against Virginia Tech. 2 touchdowns and a blocked punt. And then, of course, Titus Young, the only player that was all-conference last year at 2 positions. And then for Wyoming, of course, Marcel Gibson, a 3-year starter. He's got to be able to contain this wide receiver duo. And finally, Chris Przinski led the team in tackles with 140 last year. He's got to lead by example tonight.
On the ground for the first time, Doug Martin, the junior from Stockton, California, stacked up. After a pickup, maybe a 3, they'll mark him down to the Cowboy 45-yard line. And you can check out tonight's starting lineups on the top of your screen. Some good talent on this football field tonight, including Doug Martin. He had 12 carries in that opener against Virginia Tech, 83 yards. They like to mix it up with Jeremy Avery, also DJ Harper. Avery's more kind of a wildcat back. On second down, and call it 6. Boise State stays on the ground, and slipping through is DJ Harper, junior from Cypress, Texas.
Well, if Wyoming's defense is going to be successful tonight, they've got to be able to tackle. Well, there's been a couple missed tackles and a broken coverage already on this drive early on for the Cowboys, so they've got to be able to correct that. That's something that they had struggled with last week against Texas in their first game against Southern Utah, combined 55 missed tackles.
3 wideouts, top of your screen, a little pitch and catch. Titus Young breaks it, lowers his pads, and pushes past the 20-yard line. Przinski, the free safety, we'll hear his name and number many times tonight. defensive team captain for Wyoming with the tackle.
And this is what Boise does so well, is get speed and space. They get the ball to Titus Young. They do a great job of stretching the field vertically. A lot of shifts and formations cause confusion for the defense, but when it comes down to it, this Boise State offense simply executes like we saw in that last play.
How about Titus Young? He was an all-WAC first-team performer both offensively and as a kick return specialist. Not much. Ben Durbin, the left tackle, with the stop.
This is what Wyoming's going to have to do. The backside guard pulls here on a simple power play, but the defense fills. They get a hat on a hat. This is what they didn't do last week, and the linebacker does a great job of filling the hole and doing a good job of getting the play. Brian Hendricks showed up big.
Durbin and Hendricks. That brings up second down, and let's call it nine. Shotgun, Moore. Looks right, then left. That ball is off the hands of Titus Young, incomplete. Third down, Boise State.
That's one of Boise State's favorite plays, the bubble screen. We saw early on what Titus Young can do when he gets the ball in space. You talk about how good of receivers these group of receivers are for Boise State, but they also do an excellent job blocking downfield. Tommy Gallarda, Chandler Cope, Chris Potter, Burroughs, those guys are blockers downfield. And as an offensive lineman, I loved when I saw the little guys getting out there and getting nasty, and Boise's group does it really well.
Three wideouts near side against shotgun exclusively by Kellen Moore. They send Pettis in motion on third down and nine. Peddling back Moore all day to throw, just a simple up and out. And the ball is grabbed by Pettis, his second catch of this series, and it's going to be close to a first down around the 9 or 8 yard line.
Well, plenty of time, as you mentioned, for Kellen Moore to throw the football, and Pettis just does a good job. When you have that much speed at the wide receiver position, defensive backs have a tendency to play soft. You really have to be able to mix and match. Sometimes be aggressive, use your hands, sometimes give them space. But down here in the red zone, Boise's dangerous. They'd like to go to Pettis and Gallarda. They're in the Wildcat now.
Broncos move the chains. First and goal to goal, Jeremy Avery. You can tell the Cowboys expecting the Wildcat formation. Ghali Muhammad, the weak side linebacker, with the tackle.
Ghali Muhammad was recruited as a safety, and he played like one on this play, filling. You have to know what's going to happen and what to expect when you get into the Wildcat. Jeremy Avery, a 1,000-yard receiver from last year, has had some success out of this formation, but I really like what I see in key plays for this Wyoming defense, having some success stopping the run.
Now we see the traditional eye for the first time. Not much, and the Cowboy fans roar their approval. That will force a third down and goal, and they mark it at the 6 yard line. Purcell, Napton, the tackle and right end team up to make the tackle.
This defensive line, Craig, has been pretty impressive. They switched from a 3-4 to a 4-3 this year. They have a lot of their ends, Bazunes and Napton, that were former linebackers, so they're not that big, but they do a really good job of holding the point. Did a great job against Texas, and they appear to be doing a great job so far in this ballgame early on up front.
Yeah, smaller but faster to the football. DJ Harper sets up alongside of Moore, pumps once to the end zone, almost intercepted, and that brings up fourth down for Boise State.
Well, what Boise State likes to do down here in the red zone is get the football to their tight ends. They rush forward with some stunting up front. Kellen Moore almost throws an interception, which would have been his fourth in the last 475 passes that he's thrown. Another missed opportunity, however, for this Wyoming team. A turnover at that point in the game is the exact thing that you need to ride the momentum.
Brotsman will kick from Meridian, Idaho. The ball placed down to the 14. This will be a 24-yard attempt. Kick is up and through the uprights. And so Boise State stopped inside the red zone, but they get three off the foot of Brotsman.
College football on the CBS College Sports Network is brought to you by Bass Pro Shops. Your adventure starts here. By Sonic, America's drive-in. And by Allstate. Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you like Allstate. Are you in good hands?
Welcome back. War Memorial Stadium, only the eighth night game in stadium history. That day dates back 61 years. And sooner than later, Aaron Taylor, lights will come on here in Laramie. 3-0. Boise State after the 24-yard field goal by Blatzman. Good return. Watch out inside the 35 to the 33-yard line.
That's Zach. He's one of the big playmakers. They like this young man's speed. Had a big game last week against Texas. And in a game like this, when you have a little bit of a talent mismatch and you're Wyoming, you have to be able to create some plays and some opportunity, and getting some good movement field position helps. And one of the key matchups for this game, and there's a lot of them today, is going to be Clayton Kerb in the left tackle for Wyoming going against Shea McClellan, who had 2.5 sacks last week against Virginia Tech. Pass protection or pressure is going to be critical to whoever wins this ball game.
Little option. Keeper, Curtis Samuels. Curtis Samuels, 6'2", 215, a sophomore from San Jose. So we see Dave Christensen with a little twist. They throw. Now they throw the option at Boise State.
Got to be able to get Carter Samuels' legs involved in the run game. Only averaging 1.9 yards per rush. That's not going to be able to get it done. And Boise's among the best at stopping the run.
Shotgun, Carter Samuels pulls it down in trouble. Tries to skip out of a tackle and pull down at the 25-yard line.
Boise having some success pretty early on, being able to pressure Carter Samuels. They've got some playmakers on this Wyoming offense, but if you're not able to protect the passer, it's going to be a long night for them. Wyoming has to be able to get some time. And Boise's not bringing any sort of exotic blitzes. They're just bringing their guys up front.
Fast linebackers, Aaron Tevis in on that tackle. That takes the ball back to the 26-yard line. Boise State showing blitz. Oh, there's a bad snap. Carter Samuels not ready. He's going to have to cover up, and he is tackled. Ball is still loose, and it's a touchdown, Boise State. Shea McClellan recovers the fumble for a touchdown.
Well, you wonder if you see Carter Samuels point to the left. He wasn't even looking at the snap. There was some miscommunication there. What he needs to do, however, when that ball's rolling, is kick it out of the back of the end zone to be able to get the touchback. When he misses the ball there and the ball squirts out, it gives Boise State to do an opportunity to do that, which is a touchdown. That's two costly mistakes on that play for the Cowboys.
Point after attempt is set to go. They're going to review this play now here upstairs. So before the PAT, we'll get a review.
Early on the preceding play is under further video review.
I would imagine, Craig, they're trying to see if Carter Samuels had possession of it inside the end zone. See here, corner walks up. He's not even looking when Nick Carlson, the center, snaps the ball to him. They're trying to determine if right there he had possession of it. Then Shea McClellan, one of the key matchup players we talked about, falls on it.
No, that ball's out. That's a good angle.
Been some costly mistakes early on for this Wyoming team that have cost them 10 points.
You know, Ryan Winterswank, number 98, was in there. I think he was just punching, but the ball was never really cradled in by Carter Samuels. And then Shea McClellan, the other defensive end, rolls over and jumps on the football. And that's rare, as you know. Defensive tackles usually, or defensive ends, don't get a lot of touchdowns.
And especially at 7,200 feet when they have to hustle to be able to get them. And that's really a mark of this Boise team, is that they're hustlers, and Wyoming's shown an ability to do that. But right now, it's been more of a case so far in this ball game, very early in this first quarter, of Wyoming miscues more so than it is execution on Boise's
part. If you
had
to make the call, is that control or not?
It's not control. I think it's a touchdown. I think the referee was standing right there and got it right.
That ball is out. That may be the best angle, as that ball was up around just off his wrist. Punched out by Winterswank, and then McClellan covers up for six.
Never fully demonstrated control.
Under official review, not the start Wyoming was hoping for, with third-ranked Boise State. You look at McClellan out of Caldwell, Idaho. He had 2.5 sacks in that opening night win against Virginia Tech 12 days ago.
And the reason he got those sacks, Craig, was from exactly what we see in these pictures that we're looking at here, which is that he was a hustler. One of those sacks, he beat the right tackle of Virginia Tech. The ball was on the right hash line and ran 25 to 30 yards to get Tyrod Taylor and sacked him. It was a hustle play. The offensive tackle did a good job blocking him, but unfortunately for him, McClellan turned his motor on, kept it going, and got the sack.
This is a lengthy review.
They're taking a good look at it. Now remember, it has to demonstrate enough evidence to be able to overturn it. There's a good look. The decision's been made, and we'll find out what they came up with.
After further video review, the ruling on the field of touchdown stands.
So the fumble recovery by McClellan stands, and the extra point is to come for Boise State.
Not the type of hole that you want to be able to dig yourself into this early on in the ball game. It's going to put a lot of pressure on that defense. Boise's got a tremendous run game. Miscues kill you, whether you're at home or on the road.
8:30 remaining here in the opening quarter. Good snap, good hole, kick is away. And splitting the uprights, Boise State takes an early 10-0 lead. A miscue, a costly miscue by Wyoming. Recovered by McClellan, Boise State by 10. Welcome back to Laramie, Wyoming. Boise State, third ranked in the country, taking advantage of opportunity. Fumbled in the end zone, 10-0 early, and a lot of Boise State fans are in the stands. Trevor Harmon set to punt or kick it away to Bulger. And Muhammad.
Wyoming seems to be a little bit of a funk. The stadium's quiet. Nothing would get it rocking more than a big return here or a touchback.
About 5 yards deep on a knee is Muhammad. This guy can run, averages 23 and a half yards per kick here in the early part of the season. Now here's the test, Aaron. How does Wyoming recover? How do they react back on the field after the fumble?
Well, I think they just have to settle down. When situations like this would happen on the teams that I played on, you need somebody to step up, preferably your quarterback or your head coach, and get everybody to settle down. Boise's not beating Wyoming. Wyoming's beating themselves, and they've got to be able to stop doing that as we see another procedure penalty right here.
Alvester Alexander,
start.
A little quick off the mark.
Number 32 of the offense. 5 yard penalty, still first down.
Well, you hit it right on. It's not the fact that Boise State is actually beating Wyoming. Wyoming's doing that just fine by themselves.
They've got to be able to settle down. And well, usually a team gets shell-shocked, but they played Texas last week. So this is their second top five team in a row that they've played.
Another flag.
As we see another penalty.
Aaron, 102,000 last week. Longhorn fans watching Wyoming.
Ball start, number 76, offense, 5 yard penalty.
That's the right tackle, Josh Leonard.
So we have a false start on Josh Leonard, Alvester Alexander, two drops, one of which would have been for an interception in the end zone, and a fumbled snap that led to a Boise touchdown so far with 8 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Not the way you want to start a ball game.
First down at 20, Curtis Samuels rolls out, throws far side, and it's out of bounds at the 15-yard line, incomplete. And Chris McNeil, the intended receiver, he is their best route runner.
Not the speediest guy. He's not a 4-4 guy, but his routes are so crisp, he sometimes runs himself open, as they say. And Austin Carter Samuels does usually a pretty good job of being able to throw the football outside the pocket, which is something I think that they're going to now because Boise's shown an ability to get pressure on him. They've got to be able to change the release point tonight to keep Carter Samuels safe.
Alexander went in motion, takes the handoff. It'll stop and go, not much. Bumped out of bounds at the 10-yard line. No gain on the play. That brings up third down.
Alexander's been their featured rusher. Watching him on film, he's definitely got some speed, but I thought he kind of tiptoed through the holes last week against Texas. To be able to have the run game And to have an offensive line that's trying to find its identity, you got to be aggressive and you got to be physical and run downhill.
Carter Samuels, third down, 19 yards to go to keep this drive alive. Shotgun at the 5-yard line. Throws it. Pop. Bolger, his favorite target, wrapped up after a pickup of, let's say, 7 to the 19-yard line. Bolger with a couple of catches tonight. 9 on the season. He averaged, coming in tonight, 25 yards a catch.
Well, talking with the coaches, they said that he's their fast twitch guy. He's got sudden movements, and they sometimes have to remind themselves to get himself off the field because of the way he just wants to stay out there and is so competitive and plays. And he's been a bit a playmaker for him. Of course, David Leonard, number 33, has been their favorite target, but it's been Bolger who's been stepping up, making plays for the Cowboys.
Punt is away, line drive. Mitch Burrows watches it bounce by. Ho-ho. Is this what Wyoming needed? Inside the 10-yard line, still rolling down to the 7. McCoy working the magic with the right foot. Boise State up early by 10. One positive, the 74-yard punt by McCoy, and there hasn't been a lot of positives to talk about.
No, there hasn't. Huron dropped a big catch on third down that would have kept the chains moving. And then Shamil Gary, one of their best playmakers, drops a for sure interception. And then a miscue between Carlson and Carter Samuels leads to a Boise State touchdown. And then, of course, that was followed up by a procedure penalty by their running back and right tackle.
Total yards, negative 19. A turnover and a drop pass along the way. Boise State back on offense inside their own 10-yard line with a 10-point lead. Kellen Moore hands off the safe call. Wide open running. Doug Martin weaves his way to the 19-yard line and move the chains first down. Tackled by Prosinski and Shamil Gary.
Well, this offensive line for Boise just does such a great job of crushing that side of the line. It's just a simple draw. And what Martin does such a good job is smacking it up in there and getting north and south. He's like a little bowling ball, that Martin.
Low to the ground, plus he's got Lawrence and Slater, Bird the center. They just built a wall for him to run by.
Slater calls him a little muscle hamster. Said it defines how he runs perfectly. 5'9" ball of muscle, but gets it up in there.
First charge, timeout, Wyoming.
So Wyoming calls a timeout. Looks like an equipment problem. We'll step aside. 6:40 to play, opening quarter.
Welcome back to Laramie, where Boise State is leading the Cowboys 10-0. You will notice Wyoming is wearing a special set of Nike uniforms for today's game. Not even the Cowboy football players knew about the unis until they walked into the locker room before this afternoon's Cowboy walk. Today is the first time these uniforms have been worn. It is planned for them to be worn only on special occasions. Craig, today is one of those.
Indeed it is. And from up top here, they look pretty sharp. Boise State's not... You can pick them up too. Or pushed out of bounds around the 26-yard line. I'd say bright colors is not missing tonight here in Laramie.
Oh, we got orange and electric blue and highlighter yellow. Taking a look at Prosinski. What a great, smart football player he was. When he was younger, he mentioned when he traveled to Boise and played them, he got kind of confused with all the shifts and motions that they do, but 140 tackles later last year, my guess is he's figured it out a little bit.
He had 11 tackles last week against the Longhorn. Shotgun, once again, Moore. Hands off, nice cutback. Still on his feet is Martin, the bowling ball. He just bowled a strike down to the 42-yard line. Propinski saved a touchdown with a shoestring tackle.
Well, as you watch this run, you'll see a couple missed tackles. One right there, another one right there, that's two. Three with a couple extra 4 or 5 yards after contact. That's what Doug Martin can do, but this is the thing that's plagued this Wyoming defense. They've got to wrap up better tonight if they hope to stop Boise at all.
How about 6 first downs already here in the opening quarter, and we just passed the 6-minute mark. Under center goes Moore, the Heisman hopeful. In motion is Avery. Pitch back, the throw, going for the deep ball. On the button, touchdown!
miss.
Razzle dazzle.
Well, Boise State will do that once or twice, and Wyoming's not scared to be able to do it as well. Taking a look at Tashawn Gibson, and Chris Brzezinski's the one that bid on that. You see him right there at the bottom of your screen. Does a good job. Harper does throwing it back, and the ball's on the money. And when you run the ball effectively, as you do when you're Boise, you have your safeties want to be able to come up. Now,
after
what we just saw right there.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, number two of the offense. This 15-yard penalty will be administered on the kickoff.
Now that is significant, Craig, because you have to remember, starting next year in 2011, that would have taken the touchdown off the board. When you have those celebration penalties like that, it's charged as a live ball foul, and that would be assessed, and they would take the touchdown off the board and move Boise back.
Pettis is the holder, and the extra point to come to try to make it a 17-point lead on Wyoming. Kick is up and splits the uprights. Some more 58 yards to Austin Pettis. Kellen Moore, 70th career touchdown. Back in Laramie, unsportsmanlike conduct pushes this kickoff back to the 15-yard line. Harmon puts a foot into it. Ghali Muhammad at the 30, finds an opening at the 40, still on his feet, breaks a tackle, and is spun down around the 50-yard line. Cowboys in fine field position, but they're down 17. What do they need to do?
I'd probably start with a first down, maybe a center quarterback exchange, getting that off. You got to be able to do something. You just got to settle down and convert. Go to your high percentage passes, your high percentage runs, and just move the chains. At some point, you got to be able to help your defense out at the very least, but settle down and run the best stuff that most people are comfortable with.
I'm with you. Help yourself. You've spotted Boise State to 17. Hand off, cut back. Alexander's got an opening. Cuts back again at the 40, and shoestring tackled around the 37-yard line. Jerron Johnson, nicely done. Two-time second-team all-whack. But what a run by Alvester Alexander.
Well, that's what you got to be able to do. He's going to see the ball. Alexander's going to get the ball here. Look how big that hole is. It creates a natural run lane. He just uses his eyes and gets north and south. That's something he hasn't been able to do this year. Great job.
And the first down for Wyoming.
I got to be honest, I'm excited for the post.
Honestly, I'm with you. Nami Kinkalongo, the freshman from British Columbia, gives Alexander a breather after that nice run, but they've got hopes for this young man, a good 200-pounder.
Come from British Columbia, Canada.
Two wideouts split to both sides of the field. They send Burkhalter in motion. Shotgun is Carter Samuels. Good protection. He'll flush and run. Pumps. Now he pulls it down and shovels it to the far sideline. Wow! Trickery from Boise State. And now Wyoming counters. Move the chains of the second first down on this drive.
This is exactly what you want to be able to do, is settle down and create some plays. Austin Carter Samuels does a good job of, when the pressure there, getting outside the pocket on his feet, eluding tacklers, and just improvising. I played with a guy, number four in Green Bay, that used to do a couple things like that.
Would his name be Favre?
Yes, it would.
Under 5 minutes to play in this interesting and wild opening quarter. And a whistle stops the play before the snap.
Second charge timeout.
And they're going to take a timeout, Wyoming.
A 30-second timeout.
It's a 30-second timeout. We'll step aside. Boise State up by 17. So a 30-second timeout. They've talked it over on the Wyoming sideline, and it'll be a shotgun formation for Carter Samuels. Handoff, nothing. In fact, a big loss back to the 32-yard line. Boise State prepared. Winter Swag, Venable in on the stop. Venable's a vocal leader on this Boise State defense, number 17. He will bark, and he'll bark loud.
Yes, he will, and he did a great job of identifying that same play to the other side that Alexander gassed him on the run. You may get him once, but it's very rare that you're going to get Boise's defense twice.
A loss of 9 on the play, second down and 19. Again, Carter Samuels, shotgun. Flush from the pocket, trying to set up a screen. In trouble, still on his back foot, throws, and a smart play to get rid of it. And that will bring up third down. And Aaron, these stats really kind of just tell the story.
Yeah, they do. I mean, you can look at this screen and know what's gone on so far in this ball game. Rushing the football was something that Wyoming talked about needing to do to get their offense to make defenses respect you. It's something they've done a very poor job of tonight. A lot of those negative yards were on the miscue on the snap. But nonetheless, Wyoming's got to be able to find a rhythm going with their high percentage stuff.
Three wideouts split to the right side. As Carter Samuels barks his signals from the shotgun, good protection, steps up, flushed, has room, on the roll, throws. Oh my! Picked off at the 15-yard line.
Little too much mustard on that. Carter Samuels had a read. His wide receiver was open and behind the safety. Keep an eye on Zach Bulger as he runs down. Then out there in the flat, he's just got to be able to put a little bit more air up underneath that football, and that would have been a huge first down conversion.
Aaron, you got the feeling that Hunter White was the intended receiver.
Yeah, put too much mustard on that. That's the touch that a Kellen Moore brings it. You see him do so well. As Carter Samuels gets older, he'll learn to be able to do that. It was the right decision and poor execution on that time for the young quarterback.
Second interception thrown this season by Austin Carter Samuels. A rocky start, to say the least, by Boise State. Oh, pounding away. That shows you the bowling ball strength of one Doug Martin.
Well, Doug Martin's own teammates hated practicing against him when he was on scout team because he is just a north-south runner. You better bring your lunch pail when you're going to tackle him. And as Przinski comes in, he takes the brunt of that.
Well, that's now, punishment.
You remember, Przinski's their leading tackler. He's not no light load of laundry right there himself.
This time the legs are taken out on Martin.
Shaking the cobwebs out a little bit. I loved it as an offensive lineman when you had running backs that would run like that. And I blocked for Jerome Bettis at Notre Dame. By the time the fourth quarter came, there were a lot of missed tackles because nobody wanted any piece of it.
Moore throws it to the near side. Young the catch and push out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Very close to a first down. And they're going to move the chains.
See a lot of hands on the hips already of the front four of Wyoming team. They're starting to feel gassed a little bit. And they've been on the field quite a bit longer than they would have liked maybe this first quarter.
Flag is tossed to the backfield.
Substitution infraction. Against the offense, 12 players in possession. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That may be the only mistake I can think of in this opening quarter. Still 2:43 to play.
Yeah, Boise's been playing pretty good, and they're a disciplined team, and that's one of the things that Chris Peterson's talked about. But you take a look at Titus Young, now sixth at Boise State for career receptions with 141. Tremendous playmaker he's been for Boise State in his career.
Aaron, he had 79 last year, 1,041 yards. What a season. All-WAC first team offense and kick return specialist. Martin dives into the pile off the left side and skips up to around the 36-yard line. He'll get the 5 yards back and a little bit more. Boy, this kid's impressive. Out of Stockton, California, Gabe Napton right in with the stop for Wyoming. And it's a hurry-up offense.
Yeah, they like to get after. And you got to remember, Doug Martin beat out Jeremy Avery, and Jeremy Avery was a 1,000-yard rusher last year.
Moore sets up the screen. Guess who? It's Martin. He's got room. He's got blockers. Stutter step at the 50, still on his feet. Still on his feet at the 40 and pulls his way to the 38-yard line. A terrific catch and run by Doug Martin. Przinski and Gibson. Marcel Gibson. There's two Gibsons on this Wyoming team in the secondary. Tashawn and Marcel.
This is what Boise does so well. They have success to get right back up and do it again.
To the flat, Avery. Stop, goes, stops and goes again and dives to the 40-yard line. He'll lose a couple. This time, Bazoon's number 44, the left end. was close to the ball along with Gibson.
Great job of 17, Keith Lewis, their Leo linebacker. Got tremendous sideline speed recognizing that play and getting upfield and forcing it back inside.
Moore all day to throw. Pitch and catch. Kyle Efall. Back up tight end, number 80. Junior out of Boise, Idaho. Homegrown from Capital High School.
So what this Boise team has quite a stable of H-backs and tight ends, and Efall's just one of those. Tommy Gallarda, Shoemaker, Chandler Cope all do a great job in both the run game and catching the football.
Well, you can run out of gas trying to defend Boise State. They run their offense in a hurry. Moore again steps in the pocket, picked off at the 25-yard line. Now a flag is thrown. It looks like roughing the passer is the call, but we've got an interception at the 30-yard line.
If that interception holds up, it'll be only his fourth.
Roughing the passer, pushing him after he threw the ball. 34 of the defense, 15 yards, automatic first down.
See Kellen Moore throw the ball, two full steps. You like the aggressiveness of Matt Berkness, but you got to be able to be smart. However, the interception stands. Coming into this game, Kellen Moore had only thrown three interceptions in his last 469 attempts. Remember, he had a drop in the end zone.
No, you take
they take
that,
this one off the board.
They take that one off the board. Tonight's Red Zone brought to you by Verizon. So this drive does continue thanks to the roughing the passer call. Titus Young, quick as a cat, weaving his way inside the 15-yard line. Finally knocked down by Durbin, the left tackle.
Wow, the list of miscues for Wyoming just goes on and on. You got to remember, Kellen Moore threw 39 touchdowns last year and was only intercepted three times. And they beat a TCU team that was the number one defense in the country in the Fiesta Bowl. They dropped two costly interceptions. Plays like that, Craig, turn ball games like this around. This is a program-defining win and opportunity over this Boise team that Wyoming is letting slip away.
And the opening quarter comes to a close. All Boise State. It's been all Kellen Moore and the Cowboys. They've owned a 17-point lead after one quarter in Laramie. As we start the second quarter here in Laramie, Boise State third ranked up by 17, and Aaron knocking on the door.
Yes, they are. The red zone's where they like to strike. Getting the ball to Doug Martin down here inside, let those big boys up front get it done. Or hitting Austin Pettis in some play action.
They fake the end round and dive it up the middle. It was stay at home defense by Wyoming. Purcell, Mertens, Napton, the big fellas up front.
Talk about Merton. Merton was a rejected offensive lineman. They wanted to give him a scholarship as an offensive lineman, a big Nass, and he said, nah, that's all right. I want to come on and walk on as a defensive lineman. Well, he did it, and he played so well, they gave him a scholarship. So you got to like the persistence of old 95.
Wildcat, Avery, inside the 10, tackled down at the 8-yard line. Well, the Wildcat caught fire a couple of years ago. NFL, college football, the high school ranks. It's cooled a bit, but there is a time and a place.
There's no question, and the red zone's a great place to do it. The reason offensive teams like to run the Wildcat is because you outgap the defense. Typically on a running play, the quarterback is a wasted player, but when you direct snap the football to somebody that is a runner, you gain an extra blocker.
And it is time for Alexis Precision Measurement. And they're going to stretch the chains. That ball, the nose, just outside the 8-yard line.
A little short.
Let's see, Eagle Eye, what do you think? Football and a half?
Yeah, about. Boise's being a little greedy. That's going to be their 12th first down if they convert this thing.
Chris Peterson and company. We talked about his success in 5 years. Amazing record of 50-4, 31-1. That's unthinkable in conference play.
He does a tremendous job, and his teams are so well prepared. And the biggest thing I see when I watch Boise play, whether it's live or on film or on coaches' tape, is that they play with a confidence. Those guys expect to win. So Austin Pettis had a big catch against Virginia Tech, and big safety came up and smacked him, and Pettis just got up and handed him the ball and didn't even phase him.
Boise State trying to push the pile and keep this drive alive. Moore digs himself out of the pile of yellow and brown. First down. Didn't need much, and he didn't get it by much.
No, that offensive line for Boise's pretty dang big.
Today's first and 10 line is being brought to you by Allstate.
This Boise's got quite a weight advantage up front against this thin but athletic Wyoming defense.
They sent a tight end in motion. Play action, the left-hander goes to the air up top. Oh, a one-handed grab, nearly pulled down, but it falls incomplete.
Intended receiver was number 85, Tommy Gallarda. Old touchdown Tommy, they call him. He had four catches so far on the season. Two have been for touchdowns. This is almost the identical play and route, the corner route by the tight end, that he made in that first touchdown against Virginia Tech in their last game.
That was a two-yarder. This would have been, oh, that's a long one, seven.
Yeah, he's not big on the long catches. He just makes them count.
Second down, goal to goal. The ball placed at the 8-yard line. I formation, Kellen Moore under center. Handoff, here he comes. Martin off the right side, he's gonna walk in. Touchdown, Boise State.
Okay, keep an eye out here on the right side of your screen. You're gonna see the good job of walling off this Wyoming defense, and great job by Martin reading his eyes, being patient, and then using his speed to get into the end zone. As a defense, you have to be able to maintain, contain. Say that fast five times.
Brotsman in to try the extra point. And the kick is up and through the uprights. Martin rushes for his first touchdown of the year. Off the right side and walks it in. Boise State in command. And back in Laramie, Boise State with the 24-0 lead. You're looking at the Cowboys defense. They are worn out. They have been worn out. Aaron Taylor by that man, Doug Martin.
He is a beast. His buddies call him the muscle hamster because he's 5'9", but built like a little pit bull. Just absolute tremendous job running the football. He's so physical.
11 carries, 75 yards, 231 yards. Already rolled up by Boise State, just one offensive yard by the Cowboys. That's Muhammad trying to work his way to the outside and drop down inside the 15-yard line.
Muhammad on return, tackled by Gavins.
And let's take a look at the Polaris razor sharp performance of the game, and his name is Martin.
And he's done a tremendous job. You see right here, he gets north and south in a hurry on the screen pass, showing his ability to be able to read his blockers with tremendous vision. And then he smacks it up in there. Watch the quickness of his feet and how light he is. That tremendous quickness of power, speed, and eye recognition makes for a pretty good running back.
Curtis Samuels, shotgun. Hands it off to Alexander, the sophomore from Houston, Texas. And it's tough to try to play against a team that has put 231 up, and we're talking probably, let's do the math, 9 to 10 yards a pop, Aaron. And all you can counter is 1 or 2 yards yourself, and you're looking at three and outs.
Yeah, there's no question. They've yet to convert a third down, although they do have 2 first downs. They've had some success with the stretch zone play running the football.
Nothing doing. Curtis Samuels dropped down. Let's go to the studios and Adam Zucker.
All right, Craig, thanks. The team Wyoming faced last week, Garrett Gilbert in Texas, having a rough first quarter passing the ball. Two early interceptions. Scott Smith tipping them both. Jarvis Phillips returning this one, 85 yards for a touchdown. It's 14-7 as they play in the second. Mack Brown 3-3 all-time in Lubbock.
All right, thank you, Adam. Boise State putting on a highlight reel themselves, 24-0. And how about Texas as we follow up on that report under Mack Brown? 3-3 record on the road against Texas Tech.
Yeah, there's a little bad blood. They all remember what happened the last time they went down there to the Lubbock area. Lost on that last second win. What a ball game that was. But I watched this Texas team play, obviously getting prepared for this game against Wyoming. And I also watched Boise's tape against Virginia Tech. And I got to be honest, Craig, I didn't think it was close. When I watched the explosiveness and the physicality of this Boise team, they looked like a far superior team than what I saw out of Texas last week.
Well, an injured player is number 41. He's a third string in. Kyrie Marshall, freshman out of Phoenix, Arizona. Looks like he's holding that left shoulder. So Wyoming looking at third down at 10 at their own 15-yard line. Three wideouts near side. Shotgun is Carter Samuels. Chungachu, Ricky Chungachu. I tell you, I put him on my all-name list.
Yes, and he's over the left guard right here, Sam Sterner, and does a good job of recognizing it and crossing the face. As an offensive lineman, you want to be able to take your guy one way or the other. Right there, Sterner allows himself to get crossed, his face crossed by Chungachu, and the young defensive tackle did a great job on the play.
Where last time McCoy booted a 74-yard punt, this one again takes a hard bounce. It's fielded at the 35-yard line and out of bounds at midfield. As for Boise State, will start their next series from Laramie.
103 touchdowns.
Yeah. Third-ranked Boise State, 24 over Wyoming. And let's check now, Aaron, the icy hot quarterback hot zone.
Well, Kellen Moore's been pretty hot so far, getting the ball to his playmakers, Austin Pettis and Titus Young, and swinging the ball out to get the speed and space with his receivers. And then this was the flea flicker play where he just puts the ball right on the money. There's a penalty following that play, but Kellen Moore, early season, preseason Heisman favorite, putting on a pretty good show so far. They don't count dropped interceptions.
No. Play action. Moore steps up in the pocket, wants a home run. He's got a man post. It hung, caught. Touchdown, Titus Young. That ball was in the air for a week.
I tell you what, I almost made a play on it. It was up in the air so long. That was tremendous arm strength by Kellen Moore, working one-on-one with Marcel Gibson. Just gets inside, and this is just pure speed. You can't coach this. Marcel Gibson did a relatively good job playing it. And Titus Young is so fast, and that ball was in the air so long, he had to stop for it, and Marcel Gibson still couldn't get there.
Extra point, Brotsman. And right now, Boise State is putting a whooping on Wyoming. 31-0. A 49-yard touchdown to Titus Young. Kellen Moore is having a Heisman kind of night. Boise State with 11:41, Aaron, left in this first half, already put 31 on the board against Wyoming.
Well, this is what's so powerful about this offense. They've avoided some miscues of their own with a couple drop touchdowns, and we have playmakers like Titus Young and Kellen Moore being able to connect as well as they did on that last play. You're going to score some points. Wyoming desperately needs to find anything that's a positive for them.
Muhammad hits the pile at the 26-yard line. Well, I talked about the arm strength of Kellen Moore. This ball was in the air a long time, and underneath it was Titus Young.
Well, you want to take a look right here. There's not much space there. Now, keep in mind that Marcel Gibson is the fastest Wyoming defender, runs a 4-3, and Titus Young runs past him, has to wait on the ball like his feet were stuck in mud. That is the difference right now between this Wyoming program and Boise's program. Not only offensive and defensive lines, but the speed at the skill positions.
Nearly 200 yards passing for Kellen Moore here in the first half. Whistle stopped the play. And it's been a night of miscues for the Cowboys. That's the third false start.
Number 69, offense, 5-yard penalty. Still first down. Well,
John Hutchins, he was a question mark to even playing this game with a foot injury. But look at the comparison here. 194 yards passing, 31 by Carter Samuels, two touchdowns. And the interception by Samuels also hurt this team early.
There's no comparison on the comparison.
There's a throw and a completion. Brings a roar of approval from the hometown crowd. And the ball is brought down by McNeil. We talked about his route running. That time he got some separation and Carter Samuels able to spot him.
Yeah, well, the reality is this Wyoming offense isn't nearly as bad as those numbers we just saw. And maybe it's taken them a full quarter to be able to settle down. But this offense, I mean, you got to remember, Dave Christensen was the guru behind the Missouri attack. It's designed to be able to get some yards and some production.
Alexander tries to slip his way to a first down, close at the 37. And they're going to move the chains. Aaron, you've been in a position on the football field, high school, pro, or college, when you're down 31 and trying to keep the emotion?
It's hard to do. You just got to kind of go out there and play for pride and get it done.
First and 10 line brought to you by Allstate. From the 36, Carter Samuels in trouble. Pocket collapses, and down he goes at the line of scrimmage. That brings up second down. Number 98, that's Winterswijk.
With that sack, he's tied for fifth all time with Jarrell Goodloe. Played for Boise between 89 and 92 for being fifth all time sack leader for the Boise State Broncos.
What I like about Winterswijk, he was a walk-on, becomes an all-whack first-teamer. From the shotgun, Carter Samuels again, pressured. Runs out, throws to the flat, far side, and there a first down. Good second effort, and the crowd applause. And give a round of applause to Alvester Alexander.
Yeah, well, we talked about the start of the game. One of the key matchups was going to be over here with left tackle Clayton Kirvin going against Shea McClellan. Great job there by the defense of Boise getting around him. You start to see that Carter Samuels is starting to get a little antsy and not feeling comfortable in the pocket, and that's adding to their woes and difficulties trying to move the football.
Third down and short at the 46-yard line. Wyoming stretches the field. There's movement up front, and could that be another false start?
It's going to be on the right tackle, number 76, Josh Leonard.
False start, number 76, offense, 5-yard penalty.
Now let me ask you, what is that a cadence problem with Wyoming, or movement and nerves that Boise State is causing the Cowboys?
Yes.
All the above.
You have to be disciplined. Typically, you're going to see that on the road, but it's quiet. You could hear a pin drop here in the stadium right now.
Offense should always have the advantage because you know what the snap count is.
There's a lot of shoulds that Wyoming should be doing tonight.
On the rollout, Carter Samuels looking downfield, throws off his back foot, tough ball, caught! Oh, my! Inside the 25-yard line. Leonard comes up with the catch, and the drive rolls on.
That may be one of the ugliest and the most ill-advised passes I've ever seen a quarterback throw, but it worked. Off his back foot, across his body, over the middle, and somehow David Leonard gets the ball. Carter Samuels' two best plays tonight were the ones he improvised. Maybe Wyoming needs to let this young man go free and make some stuff happen.
Looks like a play you draw up on the playground in the dirt.
Hey, you go to the telephone pole and turn around.
Option, they give the ball to the belly of Huron, and nothing doing. Again up front, tough, tough running against that front line of Boise State, and also the middle linebacker, Hout. Byron Hout, a six-footer.
He, of course, was a player that took the shot on the chin last year against Oregon. But watching him on tape, he's a very physical player, uses his hands well, and does a good job of shedding blockers.
A loss of 2, second down at 12, 4 wide receivers. Shotgun again. Carter Samuels to the end zone. Body is down. Is there a flag? Boy, the crowd is up in arms. That pick stands, but looked like contact and a bump or two in the end zone.
Nobody's happy. Carter Samuels looks confused and dejected as he jogs off the field, and this doesn't seem to be a whole lot that's going right for Wyoming tonight. See the receiver there. Looks to be a little bit of contact. They may have ruled it incidental. There was clearly a push there. That's a terrible call by the refs. They missed.
That's a catchable football. That was a trip. That should be, and they are now going to review.
Official timeout. The preceding play is under further video review.
George Iloka got his shove on in the end zone, which if you're a DB and your beat is smart, it's better than a touchdown, but I think the review is going to show that there was absolutely contact. Right there, you see the double hand push. You could argue that their feet touched, but the push certainly assisted in the knockdown.
Second review of the night here in Laramie. Of course, you have to, when you look at the review, Aaron, it's very simple. Indisputable.
Yep.
Evidence to turn that play back. Whatever the call may be.
No question. To me, there's indisputable evidence there. There was not incidental contact, there was intentional contact. And this Boise team's done a good job tonight so far of penalties, but in their first game, they had 11 for over 100 yards. So Peterson's teams have typically been disciplined, but this could be a costly penalty for the Broncos. And help to maybe give some inspiration and some good mojo back to this Wyoming team that just from the start of the game is something's been missing. And I was really interested to see how this team was going to come out and respond. The new uniforms, the first home game since Ruben Narcisse's untimely transition. And two teams typically, Craig, can go one of two ways. They can come out and play inspired and play lights out, or they can come out and let the emotion of losing a dear friend and a teammate get the better of you. And from what I've seen so far in Wyoming, my guess is that tonight for the Cowboys, it was the latter.
Well, the crowd came to pay their respects, all with number 12 on their shirts. It's a sea of yellow, but a very subdued crowd. But what do you expect down 31?
Yeah, there's not a lot to be excited about. I mean, there's not a whole lot that's gone right. And even when they've had opportunities, and that's what's so frustrating. When you put the film on of the first half, whenever they do that, they're going to see the tremendous amount of missed opportunities. And one of the things that Christensen, their head coach, talked about was accountability.
After further video review, the ruling of interception stands. First down, Boise State.
Wow.
I'm surprised.
I am, too. I do not agree with that.
So the feet are tangled, but I also saw contact with the two hands on the pads. But the officials stay on the call. Interception.
It's like saying the cookie jar lid was off. My hand just fell inside of it.
That happens sometimes.
And either way, you end up with chocolate on your grill.
So Moore's back under center with a 31-point lead. It's been all Boise State. On the ground, DJ Harper, junior from Cypress, Texas. This guy is dangerous. So is Martin. So is Avery. He had a 71-yard touchdown in that third quarter against Virginia Tech in that seesaw battle. What a game it was 12 days ago. Harper around the corner, finds a seam, pushes the pile, and takes a hard shot back at the 34-yard line. And now let's go back to the studio for an update with Adam Zucker.
All right, Craig, we're tied up in Big 12 country. Taylor Potts lofted one to Lyle Leong, his old high school teammate. We're tied at 14 now. Longhorns don't like, love it.
Thank you, Adam. Got a ball game, 14-all.
Old Tommy Tuberville is one of the best big game coaches they are. That's not a surprise.
Incomplete. Ghali Muhammad on coverage.
Wait, they're kick returners on good coverage? That's one of the great things about Ghali Muhammad. He's fast and big enough to play will linebacker, but also athletic enough as a former safety to be able to return kicks.
Martin the cutback to the 40-yard line. He'll be 5 yards shy of a first down if they mark him at the 40-yard line. Tackled by Ghali Muhammad.
Take a look at these two guys, man. Talk about double trouble. I mean, pick your poison on which one of these guys you want to double. Talking to the defensive staff and Marty English, they very much wanted to avoid man-to-man coverage at all possibilities.
Moore from the shotgun. Nearly picked off. Incomplete pass. Good timing by Gibson to Sean Gibson.
Great job by Gibson being aggressive there, and give some credit to this Wyoming defense. Now, this is a situation, if you're the defense, you're running off the sidelines, you got to get fired up and get your punt return team. You got to be able to build off of something. When you're down 31-0 to a very good team, you're looking for something to spark you, and a big return is a great way to do that.
First punt tonight for Brotsman at his own 26-yard line. On the run, soccer-style kick. Leonard at the 15. And Leonard chopped down at the 25. All about college football, just playing this game. You got to improvise.
Do what you do. Whoop.
And thank you, Adam. Wyoming back on offense, trailing 31-0. And Curtis Samuels with the completion. Still 6 minutes and change to play here in the first half. A dominating performance by Boise State. Brings up the conversation, Aaron, as well. Because of the critics, and if you look at the strength of schedule for Boise State, I'm wondering how long they play Kellen Moore, because he's also a Heisman hopeful. And how much you want to run up this score to prove to the voters, because Boise State hanging in that number three spot. They lost some first place votes after Virginia Tech was beaten last week by James Madison. So you know they want to try to impress.
Well, we talked about that in the open, that not only do you have to win, but you got to win impressively. And that's something that this Boise team has got to be able to do because of that strength of schedule, with the only real ranked team and formidable opponent being Oregon State left on their schedule. It's imperative that they blow teams out that otherwise the BCS voters and the coaches poll and the Harris poll people believe that they should destroy.
Curtis Samuels up top, and a near one-handed grab along the far sideline by Bolger. And those are the games remaining. Now remember, this is very early part of the season. Boise State has not played in 12 days after they had that comeback win, Aaron, against Virginia Tech. And as you mentioned, they got 25th ranked Oregon State. Maybe you'll get a little push from Nevada. Gary Anderson improving at Utah State, but still there's not a lot of competition in between now and then.
Well, there's not a whole lot of meat on that bone, and that's exactly what Boise's going to need.
Numbers 76 and 34 of the offense. His penalty is declined, fourth down.
For the non-automatic qualifier, style points count for a lot. And particularly for Kellen Moore, and if he has any Heisman aspirations, he's going to have to put up numbers that are off the charts. 300 yards and 3 touchdowns may not get it done, because if you have a guy like Ryan Mallett doing that in the SEC, voters just seem to favor that.
High punt, no fair catch. There's a flag as Boise State with a big return trying to set it up and running like the wind is Burroughs. Burroughs has a wall of blockers, but hold on. I've got one, two, three flags. Count them, two flags down inside the 30-yard line.
They could have kept throwing them. That was a pretty blatant block in the back. That's an example of not being disciplined. Players that typically block in the back are out of position.
During the return of the kick, legal block in the back, number 27 of the return team. 10-yard penalty. First down, Boise State.
And that's Jeremy Avery, the running back. See the return right there, right there. Pushes him down. The ref's going to see that every time. You're much better off as a player letting that guy go and getting a tackle for no gains than pulling a touchdown or a big gain off the board.
Yeah, and he just, Burroughs is going to talk to him and said, hey, I had him beat anyway.
What are you doing, man? You're killing me. And players talk about that in the locker room, man. You go the next day and give your guys some business when they taking away some good plays. And it's unfortunate, but you got to be able to play discipline, particularly in the special teams. There's no excuse for it. You're out of position, you're going to make a mistake. It's lazy.
Moore with the football and a 31-point lead at the 16-yard line. Takes the round the end. They pitch and catch it. Boy, trickery all night long. And Gallopin is Shoemaker. The H-back. It's amazing.
Shoemaker with the reception.
The play calls by Chris Peterson and company for Boise State. They have shown us a lot in that bag of tricks.
Yeah, no question. Shoemaker had three tackles against Virginia Tech in their previous game. And we saw Kellen Moore run out to his left. With the left-handed quarterback, defenses don't get to see play action and rollouts to their side very much. And clearly they weren't expecting that.
DJ Harper, the lone back. They throw it far side. And a catch by Chris Potter. Flag again down. And we've seen plenty of those in the first half. I think Potter's going to see the field, makes his first reception of the season. And of Westlake Village, California. We've seen Burroughs, we've seen Pettis. We know what Titus Young is all about.
This receiving corps for Boise goes pretty deep.
Illegal block in the back. Number 73 of the offense, 10-yard penalty. First down will be repeated.
So Nate Potter, the left tackle, and a first-team All-WAC selection a year ago, whistle for the infraction. And that pushes the ball back inside Boise State territory, Aaron, at the 48.
Potter's an anchor of that offensive line, only had 5 sacks last year, been a pretty good pass protector. Did give a sack up against Virginia Tech last week and a half ago.
12 days ago.
Yes.
Moore under center, rolls out to his left, fires, and it's picked. Shamil Gary, the strong safety, he's that free hitter. He was a freshman All-American. And maybe the tables turn a little bit for Wyoming as they will have the football now at the 50-yard line, and interceptions just don't happen, are not thrown by Kellen Moore.
No question. I mean, this is his first turnover of the season, and we talked about how infrequent he turns the ball over, and this is just lazy. There's nothing on that. It's a poor throw, poor posture, and Shamil Gary, this would have been his second interception. He had to hang on to that one in the end zone, and he's certainly no stranger to being able to have games with multiple picks. In his first game in college, he had 3 interceptions versus Weber State last year.
Down by 31. Wyoming will start at their own 49-yard line. A swarm of white and orange. And Cardiff Samuels takes a seat back at the 41-yard line. Hey, make sure you tune in Friday at 7 for a special look at the Wyoming Cowboys as they prepare for this game against Boise State in our third episode of College Football Confidential. We embedded with the Cowboys the past week and have the inside look at the Wyoming football program. That's College Football Confidential Friday at 7. What's that rated, by the way? PG-13?
NC-17. It's pretty spicy.
On the handoff, the motion man. Perron tackled at the 49, the original line of scrimmage. Iloka, the safety with the stop, number 8 out of Houston, Texas.
That's one of the things that Boise and Chris Peterson has done a pretty good job of, is going out of state to be able to grab players from the state of Texas, and they've got three. Iloka's one of them. DJ Harper, the running back's another. An offensive tackle, Brunell Myers.
Curtis Samuels has been running all night, throws it up. And the last time he put that ball up in that same territory, a miracle catch that kept the drive alive.
Yeah, they may have to put that one in the playbook. It was a little not executed quite as effectively as that last one, but I think that's really just a great picture and example of the desperation of this Wyoming offense. This is an offense that's been efficient, that's done a great job, and Curtis Samuels coming off a great game last week where you complete 75% of your passes on the year. And for me, I think it's been pretty simple. Boise State in their front four has just done a tremendous job of putting pressure underneath him. He just hasn't had time to throw.
Charge timeout, Boise State.
Boise State will take a timeout. Wyoming cannot convert on third downs. 1 of 8 so far in this first half. 2:50 to play, second quarter. Well, I tell you, football's become worldwide, am I right?
I mean, I'll tell you what.
How about Boise State recruiting outside the U.S., Canada, South Africa? They've got a pipeline into the Netherlands. And, of course, my man, Ricky Chungacho. That's the all-name team, by the way, from the Netherlands. But it's amazing, if you can play this game, the proof is they will find you. Great kick. Angles it into the end zone. Touchback.
Well, you say that in just a little bit tongue-in-cheek, but I think you're right about that. When Boise was building their program, Idaho doesn't have a lot of perennial 5- and 4-star players, so you got to be able to, A, go out of state, but B, develop talent. And that's what Peterson's done a tremendous job for. Because when you look at this roster and you watch them on film, these players from Boise on both sides of the football, a lot of these guys could start for any team in the SEC, any team in the Big Ten, any team in the Big 12. These are talented football players.
2:42 on the clock. Moore stays in. Hand off. Here he comes. Harper. And DJ Harper knocked down after a 2-yard gain. Let's go downstairs and check in with Brooke.
Craig, you talked about Boise State being a pipeline from the Netherlands. How about Prosser, Washington? 5,000 people strong, this tiny town known for its wine and being the hometown of Kellen and Kirby Moore. Used to be Washington State territory. Now they bleed Bronco blue. They show every Boise State game at the Princess Theater in downtown Prosser. They pack them in, even hold a raffle in the grand prize. Airfare, hotel tickets for two to the bowl game Boise State will play, and you gotta love that confidence. So the perfect way to end this is to say hello to all the Moore fans at the Princess Theater. Craig, we know you're watching.
You bet. And our best to you at the Princess tonight. I wonder what the raffle prize is.
That's what I'm saying. A free box of popcorn? Can I get some bonbons?
Touchdown passes, interception ratio out of sight. The junior. A rare interception thrown tonight by Kellen Moore, but other than that misfire, it's been all Boise State and Kellen Moore. Now a whistle's gonna stop play, and Wyoming calls timeout.
Charge timeout, Wyoming, their final of this half.
And they burned their final timeout of this first half of play. Next Saturday is a football doubleheader on the CBS College Sports Network. Today begins at 3:30 Eastern from Houston, as the Cougars will host Tulane. Then at 8 o'clock, Baylor will battle Rice. Football first right here on the CBS College Sports Network. So that is next Saturday here on the CBS College Sports Network. How about the chase? Case's chase for the Heisman.
Well, he's another guy that's going to get tabbed with the system quarterback.
Yeah.
Watching Case Keenum play, there's no question he's among the country's best in quarterbacks. Throws for a gazillion yards.
Well, his completion percentage is out of sight.
I mean, he puts the ball where it needs to be. He's a tremendously smart football player with some great receivers out on the outside, but he's going to have to put gargantuan numbers, and I think since Ty Detmer won it, he may be the last guy from the system to win the Heisman.
Shovel pass, Martin again weaving his way to the 40-yard line. This kid's special. 5'9", 212-pounder from Stockton, California. He has the entire package. I'm talking speed and power.
I mean, that's what you want. When you're a muscle hamster, you get it done. Good job of just a shovel pass right there. It's his vision and his quickness. He makes people miss. His ability to be able to change directions is special.
First down from the 40-yard line. Moore shotgun. They hand the ball off to DJ Harper. 5 yards. It's been that way all night. 5, 6, 7 yards apart.
Timeout.
You know, you were talking about Ty Detmer, the old BYU Cougar, Heisman Trophy winner, and there's another one, Andre Ware.
Yeah, these were two of the greatest, and Andre Ware run it the year after one of his teammates, and when they saw that two people could come in and do it right away back to back, that's what kind of got the system quarterback tab that was really a negative connotation. Of course, Ty, a former teammate of mine, won it in 1990 with BYU and threw for a gazillion yards. But I think what's happening now is you got to be the best player on the best team and have some marquee games and be from a traditional power. I think that's an additional caveat that it's become, and it's really a team award, an MVP award, versus taking the best player in the country. Otherwise, how could you explain that there's no defensive players?
Would you agree or disagree? Would Flutie and Ty Detmer, pound for pound, two of the toughest football players?
Well, I certainly played with Ty and watched him play, but you got to take a look at Kellen Moore and what he's been able to do. But I don't know if they get much tougher than those guys.
Shotgun is Moore.
Maybe Stable.
Play action, great call. Inside the 35-yard line. This is just easy. Highwood, the freshman from the Netherlands, with the catch, and Boise State in the hurry-up offense. They want to put another score on the board as we're under a minute to play in the first half.
Wyoming's got to be able to do something, get some pressure there, but nobody out on the outside.
Harper, oh, he's tripped up. What a tackle. Hit him right on the shoe tops, and Tashawn Gibson put that one on the highlight reel. Cartwheels him at the 15-yard line.
Good job of making the tackle. You'd like that to be a little bit further down the field, not after such a big game, but Wyoming, their key was to not get beat over the top and keep everything in front of them.
Moore's really pushing the tempo. Sets up in the pocket, throws underneath. It's caught and wrapped up quickly.
Brian Hendricks on the tackle.
Haven't had a chance to talk Hendricks much tonight, but of course he wears number 12. His number during the regular season is 8. But they're honoring Reuben tonight. That ball a little over the top. And Kellen Moore getting anxious to find the end zone. That ball falls incomplete. There's Hendricks. Make sure you stay tuned for the Verizon Halftime Report. Adam Zucker. And
well, it's talking about Hendricks. I mean, what a tremendous player he's been. Won the Fred Steinmark Award for the Colorado State Athlete of the Year. Actually was offered scholarships to Nebraska and Oklahoma for wrestling. And look at him, man. Think that guy does some curls? Curls for the girls. He's got some guns.
Yeah, he doesn't mind showing those babies off.
He's all greased up.
You know, he had 23 tackles last year against Air Force tops in the NCAA. Now another flag down in the end zone.
Charge timeout, Boise State. Their third and final of this half.
So Boise State, a 30-second timeout. So now let's see how Kellen Moore created magic on the field tonight, brought to you by Macy's. Pretty impressive first half.
Yeah, and you brought up the point a minute ago about what Chris Peterson does. If Kellen Moore wants to win the Heisman, you got to pad these stats a little bit. And there's something about having, you know, kind of the unwritten rule where you don't run up the score on somebody, but there's other things at play. And I think if you were Kellen Moore and you have a legitimate shot, he's certainly a good enough player to do it. These are the type of situations that you have to be able to take advantage of and let him get some additional touchdowns, whereas in a normal situation, you'd probably be running the ball right now.
Total yards tonight. This is not four quarters of football. This is two. 409 yards racked up thus far by Boise State. Is in Highwood in motion. Shotgun once again is Moore. Steps, throws, corner, end zone, and it is knocked away incomplete. 5 seconds to play in this first half, and Moore was knocked down to the turf. And good coverage by Gary, the strong safety. He's that free hitter.
Yeah, he is. He likes to be able to cover some ground and get a little bit of rangy. Shamil Gary was right there trying to get the ball to Shoemaker. Both those players the same height, and Gary showing you some ups as Brotsman comes on for the field goal.
Knocked down a third 24-yard field goal to start the scoring tonight in the opening quarter. This will be from 29. Little chip shot, it's up and through the uprights. So a 29-yard field goal adds to Boise State's total. Impressive numbers. They put 34 up in the first half on the road.
Well, that's about as good a half of production as you can have, but it certainly wasn't perfect on Boise's side. And for Wyoming, it certainly can't get any worse than that first half was.
And let's go downstairs. Here's Brooke.
Coach, your defense obviously very effective. Are you pleased with the pressure they're putting on their young quarterback?
Yeah, he's a good runner, and so he's hard to corral, and he can make things happen when he's outside the pocket. So real pleased with those guys getting after him a little bit.
Kellen Moore in the air, Doug Martin on the ground. You just continue to fire on all cylinders offensively.
Well, if we can get our run game going, it's going to help everything. And we've been running the ball a little bit effective, and we're going to need to continue that in the second half.
Thanks, Coach. Like you said, Craig, over 400.
College football on the CBS College Sports Network is being brought to you by Macy's and by 5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now, no 2:30 feeling later.
Welcome back to Laramie, Wyoming. Boise State with a commanding 34-0 lead. Let's go downstairs. Brooke with Wyoming head coach Dave Christensen.
Thank you, Craig. Coach, obviously some miscues in the first half. Tough to do, especially against a top five team. What did you say to your guys in the locker room?
Well, you know, until you can close the gap, you're playing for pride. And, you know, I sure as hell hope, you know, there's some pride out there. And you know, we're looking to make sure there's no quitters on this football team. And I don't think we have any. And I think we'll come back. We'll play hard in the second half. And, you know, we got to put some plays together offensively. Got to do a better job of tackling on defense.
Thank you, Coach. All right, Craig, 34-0. Definitely quite a deficit, but you have to love the Cowboys support. Still a packed house, still a sea of shirts with that number 12.
All right, thank you, Brooke. And yes, the fans are still in the stands. Let's review the first half stats. Aaron reeled in by Bass Pro Shops.
Well, there's not a whole lot to like on Wyoming's side. Negative 34 rush yards, when that's a point of emphasis for your offense, negative 34 is not going to get it done, but they weren't much better through the air. Pressure that Boise State has been able to put on this poke offense has proved to be detrimental. They've got to do something be able to get some points on the board or get any sort of production on the offensive side of the ball.
No return for Boise State. They'll start on the 20. Let's take a look at the Travelers Insurance game highlights. All Boise State.
Yeah, there was a miscue on the center quarterback exchange in the first quarter that led to the touchdown, and then the flea flicker. The Broncos bringing out some trickery of their own. Kellen Moore throwing a big pass to his big number two, Pettis, and then you see the big running back, Doug Martin, doing his job. But it's been almost offense at will for Boise State. Through the air, on the ground, they've had their way. Doing a much better job executing than Wyoming has.
Bob, Boise State with the first possession of this third quarter, and taken down from behind is Doug Martin. We were wondering how long Kellen Moore would go. I'm guessing three quarters minimum tonight.
There's no question. Wyoming hasn't really been able to put some pressure on him, so it's not like he's taking hits. So keeping him in there, getting those style points that we talked about, is something that I would imagine Boise is going to try to achieve. Be a tackle by the center, number 66, Thomas Byrd, I think. Pretty good tackle.
Now the officials are right on it. I know both coaches are begging, pleading for explanation. I think Wyoming's in terrific hands with
Holding.
Dave Christensen.
Number 66 of the offense, half the distance to the goal. First down will be repeated.
And Aaron, you're right, it was Thomas Byrd, but I like the way that he talked to Brooke. You know what? It is about playing for pride. This is about rebuilding a program here at Wyoming, and it is about holding your head up high against one of the elite teams of college football.
No question, and that's part of changing the culture, is believing in the program. And last week against Texas, when arguably the game got out of hand in the second half, Christensen was very happy with the way his team competed. They never quit. They were playing just as hard in the fourth quarter when the game was away from them as they did in the first.
Coming at you like a runaway train is Martin. Well, he gets up ahead of steam in a hurry, and he'll knock him down at the 17, maybe the 18-yard line. Shamil Gray, again, I talked about the free hitter. He was out there knocking heads. Number 7.
This kid's a good player, and he's another example of being from Tulsa, Wyoming, going out of their own backyard and getting somebody that came in and contributed to his team right away as a freshman and as a sophomore. It's a bit more different.
Second down at 13. Right up the gut goes Martin, tackled. He'll get a couple to the 21-yard line, and a host of yellow jerseys led by Mertens, a redshirt freshman from Sterling, Colorado.
Coming into this game, Craig, kind of we asked what their three keys were on defense, and it was that they had to tackle well, they had to prevent the big plays and force turnovers. Well, they did force the turnovers. They missed some opportunities there, but they haven't tackled very well at all, and the big plays have really, really hurt them.
5 wide receivers set for Boise State on 3rd down and 9. Shotgun Moore, 3-step drop, dumps it, flats. It's Titus Young, sidesteps a tackler on his way to the 40-yard line. 1st down and Moore. Well, you load it up with 5 wideouts. You throw underneath and let Titus Young do his thing.
Well, this is just what they do so good. Wyoming's in a see Titus Young is off to the left side. Go ahead and roll it. Can't see him. He's just going to drag across the screen in the zone underneath. Moore does a good job of getting the ball. And here's the missed tackles right there that we talked about. You're not going to win very many matchups and very many ball games if you can't tackle better than that. That's still got to be a point of emphasis from Wyoming. And they're still struggling. You just can't do that against a team like Boise.
Today's 1st and 10 live brought to you by Lexus. 1st and 10 at the 40-yard line. Moore, little pitch near side. Martin lowers his pads to the 47-yard line. Shamil Gray. Gabe Napton also in on the tackle. Former linebacker turned defensive front line. And we got a player down.
Looks like it's Mitch Burrows, number 20. Out there blocking, just gets rolled up on. Grabs that right knee.
Well, the crew is out taking a look at Mitch Burrows. We'll step aside. Coming back to Laramie after this. Well, the lights are on at War Memorial Stadium. 8th, 9th game in stadium history that dates back 61 years. And right now, not having a good time as Burrows is being looked at. Ankle, knee. Cutting Martin and pushes a pile to the 46-yard line. Move the flags, 1st down, drive rolls on.
Be ground and pound, I would imagine, for Boise's offense. When you're up like this in a ball game, it's a good opportunity to be able to get some experience in a real game situation for some of your younger players. There's obviously the ulterior motives of padding stats and having some impressive wins, but it's also a good opportunity to get some young guys some roll.
1st and 10 line brought to you again by Lexus. Nothing fancy, simple off the right side. Following the blockers is Martin. And what looks to be what should be a 4 or 5 yard gain turns out to be nearly 10.
Well, that's just the power of that offensive line. I think at this point in the ball game, when you have that big size advantage of those big laundry and pancake eaters up front, it starts to wear on you. I've been impressed with Wyoming's defensive line and all the changes that have occurred and all the players that they lost to graduation. They've been able to hold their own this long, but at some point, Boise just dominates physically up front.
98 yards from Martin as he takes a breather. Quarterback keeper is Kellen Moore. Boy, did he sell that to Jeremy Avery?
That was actually Michael Coughlin.
Yes, Coughlin just came in. My mistake, Moore took a break, and they throw in the senior from San Diego.
I was wondering, I thought the same thing, but he had a little bit of giddy up in that step. And I said, man, Kellen Moore looks fast. And of course, that was Coughlin. And that's a perfect example, Craig, of what we were talking about, of getting his blood going a little bit and getting him in the game. That'll keep you focused.
How about that? Runs back over, takes off the helmet, puts on the headset. Moore jumps back on the field, and now there's flags down. Aaron, you and I were talking earlier about building
time. Before the snap, false start, number 61 of the offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Building top 10 programs, you have to have the depth, 1 through 3.
No question, you have to be able to do that, because as the season wears on, you can ill afford to be able to have injuries. And you take a look at a team like Alabama, they lose Mark Ingram, the Heisman Trophy winner, and don't skip a beat because they have a stable of running backs behind them, and Trip Richardson comes in and does a tremendous job. Now Mark Ingram comes back, but at each position, if you're 2 or 3 deep, it puts you in a much better position at the end of the year.
Play action pass, a lefty, Moore. Incomplete.
Fourth pass was incomplete.
And that brings up second down. Let's check in with Brooke and see what she has on that injury to Burroughs.
Craig, yes, Burroughs, of course, helped off with help, took him to the training table. He was pointing to the right side of his calf, moved his hands kind of like a twisting motion. Again, I'm just telling you what I see. Let's make no assumptions. But Austin Pettis right by his side the entire time, patting him on the chest. Since that, he has actually got up. He's walking on it gingerly, but he's walking on it.
All right, Brooke, thank you. We'll keep an eye on Burroughs. Little delayed draw, stiff arm. Not going to work this time, as Martin is taken down for a loss back at the 38-yard line. And how about Willis, the redshirt freshman, Mark Willis out of Oak Park, Illinois, 85 with the tackle.
He's kind of their pass rush specialist, somebody they like to bring in at the 3 technique and their nickel packages and their 6 technique. See him, he's right here. Does a good job of rushing the passer. He's running a stunt right there, just kind of falls into the draw and does a good job of wrapping up and making the tackle.
Third down, Boise State at the Wyoming 37-yard line. Shotgun again, Kellen Moore. 5-step drop, good protection, up and over the middle, caught on right on stride. What a beautiful ball. Kellen Moore, that's what happens when you have protection. And you've got a player running across the seam and you connect.
Kellen Moore sitting back there making sandwiches, but that's the accuracy. Just puts the ball right on the numbers, exactly where it is you want to be. And Aaron Brooks does a good job of covering it up, knowing he's going to get hit by Pruszynski, and holds on.
Got a word for you. A plethora of wide receivers.
Oh, you went all SAT on them. It's a veritable cacophony of talent at the skill position outside.
Field goal, Brotsman. They'll place it down at the 28-yard line, a 38-yard boot, and it's up and true. So Brotsman, 3 for 3 from the field tonight with his right foot, and Boise State adds to their lead. Boise State 37-0 over Wyoming, 9 minutes on the mark left to play here in the third quarter. Now you talk about Kellen Moore, a Heisman Trophy candidate. He's looked nearly perfect tonight. Other non-qualifier conferences that have players that are in the mix, Case Keenum for one from Houston. And you have to talk about Ricky Dobbs as well from Navy. But yet Ricky's had a tough go early this season.
Yeah, it wasn't quite the start of the season that they expected to have for him. 3 rushing touchdowns only.
Whoa, that ball is loose. Everybody's still on the pile. And we've got a scrum at the 35-yard line.
Boy, I tell you, Wyoming recovers, but the miscues just seem to continue to mount up.
Well, Bulger, I love the effort going after that ball, and then Boise State tries to come in. Well, that was his own teammate.
Well, he saw the ball pop out, and he's being heads up. You got to give him credit for swarming to the football.
That was Huron saying, you know what, I'll take it and go from here. Cowboys at the 35, down by 37 points, under 9 minutes to play, third quarter. Carter Samuels, far side, not much.
Winston Venables, fast. He closed on that so incredibly fast.
Well prepared. This defense, I tell you, there has been nothing they have not seen and gone on the hunt for.
No. And this is a lot like their offense in terms of the spread looks, and I mean, it's very similar. So these players on defense are suited for this sort of offense, as we saw in that last play.
Five wide receivers, they go option. Carter Samuels. You could hear the pads pop, and that was Venable again, and he's barking. We talked about how vocal he is, but I could hear that. It's still ringing in the stadium.
Venable's been all over the place, bringing the wood. Take a listen.
You know what? It's a good thing you got a chin strap.
Yes, it are.
First and 10, Cowboys play action. Curtis Samuels and another pop. I am telling you, it is big time hitting going on tonight. That one's Iloka. The safety, George Iloka.
It seems like they're a couple steps ahead of whatever it is that Wyoming is going to do. Good job of pitching and catching on Wyoming's side. They've got a little bit of a drive going, but Boise's defense looks like they may be bringing some heat off the outside of the corner blitz.
They drop back. Hand off again, the pads pop. This time Tevis, the middle line or the weak side linebacker with the stop. You think that Boise State lets up with a 37-0 lead? No.
Gas pedal. There's too much at stake for them to do that, but at some point, if you're Chris Peterson, you have to start to think, yes, you want the style points. Yes, you want to win convincingly. Yes, you want to give your junior quarterback an opportunity to win the Heisman, but you've got to manage injuries as well.
Third down and long, Cowboys. In the flat, pitch and catch, nothing fancy, big yards. Alexander rumbling to the 35-yard line of Boise State.
When all else fails, throw the ball to your back at a check down out of the backfield and get him in space and let him run. Those quick passes like that can serve as an effective run game. It was a five-step drop just in one-on-one coverage. It does a good job of running away from the safety.
Tonight's first and 10 line brought to you by Lexus. Cowboys trying to break a drought. Play action up top, got a man wide open. Run it in, touchdown, Wyoming.
Greg Sijari on the touchdown. Broken coverage on Boise's standpoint, but that was a much needed touchdown for this Wyoming team.
First career catch, first career touchdown, and the extra point is no good. Wyoming finds the end zone for the first time tonight, 6:21 to play. 37-6, Boise State. Six plays, 65 yards, 2:39 off the clock. And you remember what the conversation Brooke had with Dave Christensen, and it was real simple. Let's play with some pride. You know what, let's finish this thing out. If you want to compete and get better, go play football.
There's no question, and what better way to do it than to get on the board late in the third quarter, and it's just a sign that there's no quit in this team.
Here comes Tadish Young, turning the corner, dancing backwards, going the other way. Stiff arm, still on his feet at the 5. Stiff arm, still on his feet at the 10. To the 15-yard line, Tadish Young ran a mile to get to the 18-yard line.
He was looked like he was running for his life, but again, there's missed tackles even showing up on the special teams, or as they like to call them here in Laramie, the special forces.
Count them.
Tadish Young breaking off to his left. Delay. Good blocks, people holding their blocks. There's one. Great job staying on his feet. There's two. Finally get him out of bounds.
Oh. He did not hesitate delivering some pain on that Wyoming sideline, so Boise State starts this drive at their own 19-yard line. Moore, the left-hander. Oh, what a catch. What a throw. They're going to count it. Yeah, complete at the 27-yard line. And a beautiful grab.
Tyler Shoemaker again.
We're going to call it incomplete. Shoemaker, a junior from Meridian, Idaho. Take a look.
Goes the out. Did not look like he had possession of it before he went out of bounds. You see the ball bobbling there.
And the foot on the line. Good call. Second down, 10, 19-yard line.
I think the officials have done a really good job tonight in terms of making their calls.
So the Heisman Trophy candidate goes back to work, sets up a screen. And boy, the yards are going to pile up as DJ Harper is bumped out of bounds at the 30-yard line. So in Laramie, Wyoming, third-ranked Boise State with a 37-6 lead on the Cowboys of Wyoming. War Memorial Stadium sold out tonight. Only the eighth night game ever in this stadium. And this town really alive the last couple of days.
Yeah, there's no question. There's been a lot going on here. Night games are always good because you have all day to get primed up for the contest. And
a little tailgating all day long.
Little bit, little tri-tip, little bratwurst.
Harper pops through the hole to the 39.
But really impressed, though, with the way the crowd stuck around. And the fans here in Wyoming are very supportive of this team and very reminiscent of the players themselves. The players on the field aren't quitting and the fans aren't giving up on them.
Second down short. I formation. Hand off right side. Harper moved the chains to the 41-yard line.
Greg, we're getting to the point in the ball game where I think we're going to start to see some of the other players come in. DJ Harper, the junior. He's a regular player on offense.
Aaron, that last carry by Harper just put Boise State over 500 yards of total offense tonight, still with just under 5 minutes to play in the third. Moore, draw, big hole, left side. Well, the blocking's been terrific. Nate Potter, Joe Kellogg, Bird, the center. And Aaron, you know, not just Holzer, I'm talking about, you know, my arms. I'm talking gaps.
There's been some extremely big gaps and some gashing going on. And I think that's a testament to the success that Boise's had by spreading guys out, but also by their big offensive line that has such a weight advantage pushing around a rebuilding defensive line.
Fumble snap. That's a rare miscue tonight on second down. They're going to mark it at the 45-yard line. Interesting because Moore is such an exclusive shotgun quarterback. It's got to be a little different pressure for his center, Bird, when he comes underneath.
Yeah, it's a changeup, and you see sort of things like that can happen when you change things up a little bit. Now he goes back, obviously, to a little bit more comfortable position, but Thomas Bird, you got to be able to snap the ball both ways. I'm certainly he's done that quite enough.
Harper in motion. Moore sets up, throws, complete, first down, and Moore. Now Boise State continues to give second effort, and Kellen Moore applauds that effort. He applauds because his dad's continued to grow tonight.
Yeah, no kidding. That was Chris Brzezinski on the tackle, one of the surest tacklers that they have on this team. Had 140 last year, but you know, you miss a tackle there and they get 6-7 additional yards and move the chains.
That was Potter again, too. He had a catch in the first half, pulls down his second of the season here in Laramie. Shotgun, a quick hitter up the middle by Harper. Aaron, when you break this Boise State team down, you have to love the motion. They show you different personnel sets, and it's kind of like a broken option where he continues to move after the ball's been given, and you almost have to play at home so you don't get beat.
No, and that's exactly why it is they do that, and the shifts in the motion force the defense to be disciplined and with their identification.
Coughlin has checked in. So Moore gets a breather. Is he done for the night? We'll wait and see as Coughlin, who likes to run, is tripped up and dropped to the 20-yard line. The senior from San Diego, and he's a big, big guy at 6'5", 221. And just before, it's one and out. And Coughlin, I'm get betting once again, Aaron's going to take that helmet off, slip on the headset, and go back to work.
And it's interesting, they're using Coughlin like they usually do with Jeremy Avery as the Wild Bronco back. Kellen Moore was in the game on that last play, split out wide. So Avery's coming in as a running back, but he also obviously can throw the football as well.
Martin is lined up deep. Play action. And the lefty with a day and a half to throw. Near sideline, it's caught. The tight end with the catch.
Really seems like Wyoming's defense is playing soft in their zone, sticking true to their strategy coming in, which is to keep everything inside and in front of you, not give anything up over the top. Makes himself susceptible underneath.
Tonight's Red Zone brought to you by Verizon. What a game for Shamil Gary. That was his 12th tackle of the night. Still with a fourth quarter to play. Wildcat formation, Boise State. Avery's going to keep it. Changes directions at the 10, at the 5. Flags are down, and Avery is pushed out at the 3-yard line.
Going to be holding on number one, Titus Young. Usually does a good job on the outside. Missed tackles by Wyoming, but the miscues were bigger on
holding
that play as Boise gets
one of the offense. 10-yard penalty. Second down will be repeated.
Good call, Titus Young. Whistle for the infraction.
Well, we like to say in the offensive line business that if you're not holding, you're not trying, but that's going to get you caught every time. Grab a yellow jersey, you get a yellow flag to match it.
I think the Cowboy had a handful of face masks, too. Young trots to the near side. Second down. And 7. Young goes in motion. Wide open, caught at the 10, and his legs were cut underneath. Galarga.
Galarga with the reception. Muhammad makes
they've got Efaw as well. They've got, you know what, it goes back just to overall depth. Aaron Taylor, I mean, at the wideouts, at the tight end position, at the running back. And that's why you're number 3 in the country.
Yeah, there's no question. There's a lot of reasons why and a lot of good teams that do the same thing.
Boise State again knocking on the door. First and goal, ball at the 3-yard line. Right up the gut, touchdown. Walking in is Harper. And Boise State adds another 6.
Didn't seem to be much resistance on that one there, Craig. You have to wonder at some point, a lot of Boise players with their hands on their hips. Looking tired, looking dejected a little bit. But there is no quitting this team. And of course, you can't take any credit away from DJ Harper and that offensive line of Boise.
Extra point would make it 44-6. And that one just sneaks inside the right upright. Harper the touchdown. Boise State 44-6. Team ticks on the third quarter clock. A dominating performance tonight by Boise State. They own a 44-6 lead. Number 3 team in the country, Kellen Moore. A terrific job leading the way tonight. Doug Martin on the ground. Titus Young and Austin Pettis.
Boise's win streak continues. Second longest to Alabama.
Bulger at the goal line. Bulger hits a wall and spins to the 21-yard line. Alabama wins again today. And of course, Boise State rolled in tonight with 15 consecutive wins. And coming up after the game on Inside College Football Extra, Adam Zucker, Brian Jones will bring you the latest news from around the gridiron, as well as highlights, analysis from all the big games today.
Well, now it's time for this team to show some heart and move the football. And it's execution, Craig. That's all that's kept them from doing what they're trying to do tonight is execution.
And it started early. You know, you go back to the first quarter, they just dug themselves a hole and been trying to climb out all night long. Three quarters are in the books. And we'll come back for the final 15 minutes. All Boise State here in Laramie. 44-6. We're coming back after this on CBS College Sports. Fourth quarter underway in Laramie, Wyoming. And the catch pulled down by Bulger, the wide receiver, number 89. 15 minutes left to play. A dominating performance by Boise State tonight. Rough for Carter Samuels, Wyoming's sophomore quarterback out of San Jose. They spread the field once again. Four wide out. Shotgun is Carter Samuels. Low snap, three-step drop, pocket collapses, and a sack back at the 16-yard line. Aaron, dominance. You want a definition of dominance? Here it is, through three quarters.
I mean, the first thing that jumps out at me is the rush yards. I mean, you have no chance if you cannot rush the football. Even if you're a passing offense, you have to be able to make the defense respond to you. I mean, Boise's run 68 offensive plays. Wyoming's only run 39, and there's about a 10-minute difference in time of possession.
Moore puts up 370 yards, a couple of touchdowns. Martin's rush for 105. That's a beautiful punt. Taken back inside the 25-yard line. Watch out. Titus Young is on the move, still on his feet. Fighting to the 40-yard line. That punt was a beauty and maybe a case where you overran coverage.
We can do it live.
A rough go tonight for Dave Christensen in his second year. 8-7. Last year they go 7-6. They beat Fresno State in a wild double overtime win in the New Mexico Bowl, 35-28. Kind of re-sparks interest with Wyoming football. But tonight, a tough go. Coughlin in at quarterback. Avery off the left side. And a pile at the 40, call that the 39, 38-yard line. Purcell, the left tackle, in on the stop, number 50.
I was wondering guys like that that have the hair coming out of the back of the helmet. If I played against a guy like that, there's no question I would pull it.
I think you'd probably carry a little pair of scissors in there and try to get a snip or two.
Oh, no, I'd go straight handfuls, Craig.
To the 35-yard line, and let's check in now. Adam Zucker.
All right, thanks, Craig. Notre Dame trying to avoid going over Michigan. Dane Chris, the Theo Riddick, third touchdown pass of the game, tied for the third time in East Lansing. Back to you guys.
All right, Adam. So Notre Dame, Michigan State. What about the Irish here, my friend?
I'm telling you, they got to find a way to finish and get the win. That's what Brian Kelly's specialty is. They've got some potential there. The players are there. I've really been impressed with the way the defense is playing better this year than they did last year. Dane Chris is obviously a quarterback that, once he fully understands his system, I think is going to be able to be a tremendous player in college football. Notre Dame's close. This isn't going to be their year. They're going to be a 7-8 win team this year. But next year and the year after that, historically, is when Brian Kelly's teams have kicked in, and they tend to do really, really well. I hope.
Nice tag on that comment. Coughlin under center, I formation. Clock runs under 12 minutes to play. Quick as a cat is Avery. past the 25 to the 23-yard line. And Mr. Moore is done for the night, 370 yards passing. The only miscue, that interception, but he went 20 of 30 tonight, two touchdowns. And I'm sure that, again, this score plus those numbers will grab the attention of Heisman voters and also voters and the coaches and AP poll.
Yeah, his touchdown numbers are a little down this year compared to last year, only four so far through the two games. But the 370 yards, that's going to get some, that's going to get some eyeballs. Boise really needs to get over 50 points, though, as they have a miscue here.
Iwat went in motion, flags it out.
Prior to the snap, false start, number 42 of the offense, the 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's the fullback, Jake Hess.
He's excited.
Sophomore from Reno.
Doesn't play a whole lot, and it's probably going to be a lead play on that one. He had to make a critical block and couldn't hold his horses. But going back to Kellen Moore, I mean, he's had some tremendous numbers here tonight, but he avoided a couple potential miscues in the two dropped interceptions that he threw. It would be a whole different, maybe ball game, but certainly different statistical night had he had two touchdowns and three interceptions.
Hand off, Avery switches directions and slides to about the 27-yard line. So what do you think? Kellen Moore tonight, Ricky Dobbs, the Navy quarterback, Case Keenum out of Houston. He's got that high quarterback rating, but those are Heisman hopefuls from the non-qualifying conferences.
Yeah, it is. And we talked about Ricky Dobbs earlier and what he did or didn't bring to the table so far. Case Keenum being kind of a system quarterback, so there's a knock on him. If Kellen Moore with five touchdown passes can get to the national championship game and put up some huge numbers, he just may have a shot, but it's not likely.
Coughlin finds Avery, stop and go, and is pushed back to the 24-yard line. 1-2-3-4 Cowboys right on top of Jeremy Avery, led by Schobert. That's number 35. He's one of those guys that they went, he's from Munich, Germany.
Yeah. The way they found him is they received a videotape, and his highlight tape started with him with his shirt off, just kind of staring, looking at the camera, and the coaches said, all right, he looks good, but can he play? And then all of a sudden they put the film on, and he's running around making tackles like crazy.
That ball is picked up off the fumble, and Wyoming recovers at the 40-yard line. Devin Harris, the redshirt freshman. Everybody in Fountain, Colorado is cheering for this young guy, and the Cowboys get back on the field on the offensive end.
Now it's going to be Boise that has the miscues, and Wyoming comes up. Can the Cowboys have a comeback? Well, probably not, but it's still a good play for their defense. Great turnover.
Back in Laramie, still got some diehard fans in the stands. 44-6, Boise State. Cowboys with the football at the 39-yard line. Ball is up, and it takes a bounce, incomplete. That was McNeil, the intended receiver, number 80. Sophomore, Simi Valley, California.
Ebo McKinde, number 37, read this all the way and almost picked that off. Excuse me, that wasn't McKinde, but telegraphing the passes, watching film on Carter Samuels. One of the things I wondered was whether or not he locked onto his receivers, and he certainly did there on McNeil.
Four wideouts. Carter Samuels scrambles out of the pocket and close to a first down. They're going to mark him just shy at the 48-yard line.
This is a young mobile quarterback. He scored their only touchdown last week against Texas on a scramble using his legs and making plays.
How about that game last week? 18-yard touchdown, by the way. It's 7-6, and people go, uh-oh. But then Texas rolls off the final 28 points.
And what happened in that game, and the turning point, was a big run and a missed tackle by the Wyoming defense. And from then on, I think Texas gained the confidence that they needed and kind of downshifted and put things in the gear.
Carter Samuels tried to stretch it over the top. Had a wide-open man, incomplete. That was Burkhalter. Was that Leonard?
That was actually Leonard.
David Leonard.
And had that ball been on the money, Craig, he would have hit his head on the goalpost. Good job being physical. We talked about at the top of the game that he's like a power forward playing football. He's not flashy, but he uses his body and his hands well and did a great job matched up against Jarrell Gavins on that last play.
You know, he was a big target last year. 77 receptions in 2009. He's got 9 grabs coming into tonight. And now whistles will stop play. Wyoming really spread it out with 5 wideouts.
Charge timeout.
And a timeout. We'll call timeout with 8:33 to play. Down the stretch in Laramie. We'll be back. It is a buggy night in Laramie, Wyoming. Aaron, you have to see it to believe it.
I'll tell you what, if I was a gecko lizard, I'd be pretty full right now.
How about a bat flying in? It'd be a feast.
I was a little disappointed. I thought we were going to get some bat action here in the high plains of Wyoming, but apparently not. Don't they have caves here?
So they're going to punt on 4th and short. And a strong leg, fair catch, pedaling back at the 4-yard line.
That was a boom.
That's a boomer. Hit a few bugs. And how about a look at tonight's sonic quality drive? This is how you do it.
That's how you not do it. That was a costly interception for him, which gave Boise the ball back. And then they feed the ball to their playmakers, Martin. 2 catches for 40 yards so far tonight, doing a good job both running the football on the ground and through the air. He's a powerful, dynamic player with a big night tonight.
Why is it the sonic quality drive? 13 plays, 85 yards, 5 minutes off the clock. That made it 24-0 Boise State. That was a statement drive.
They needed to have that one, and they sustained it. It was a long drive. A lot of times, offenses can make mistakes when they've got to put those 12-play drives together, but Boise, because of their discipline and because of their execution, were able to move the ball down the field.
8 minutes, running up on 8 minutes left to play. Moore is done for the night. Coughlin has checked in, the senior quarterback out of San Diego. And what you're seeing now is that Coach Chris Peterson gets a chance to really go deep into his bench to let players get experience who will soon be starters on this team one day. And Wyoming, of course, stays with most of their starters. It's about experience and trying to build some confidence if possible. There's a stick. Oh, baby. That ball's out. That ball came out. But what a hit by Prosinski. I mean, that is highlight material.
That was a great job. There were a couple missed tackles. That was just a simple power. But the right tackle, Brunell Myers, number 64, comes up with it. But Chris Prosinski, who got run over earlier in the game by Martin, returns the favor here and sticks his teammate Jeremy Avery and gets some of his street credibility back. Great hit by that young man.
All Mountain West Conference first team preseason pick in 2010. He's a hitter and he put his hat right on the football. And again, the pads continue to pop. If there is one plus, I would think that Marty English, the defensive coordinator for Wyoming, has to like at least the way this team continues to pursue the football. Now, granted, Boise State most likely has second and 13 players on the field, but I don't see a let up by Wyoming.
Well, when you break it down, the reality of it, when you get it down to its lowest common denominator, you're competing against yourself and the standard that you set against yourself regardless of the opponent. So the very least you should be able to do as being a football player when you're on the field is give effort and hustle. So you're right. He does have to feel good about that. In Wyoming, there's no quit in this team.
Another hard stick. That's Gary with another tackle in this football game. That's 16 tonight for Shamil Gary, the freshman All-American from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Also has that interception. Boy, if he doesn't garner some all-conference honors this week, I'd be very surprised.
Well, I'll tell you what, he had 98 tackles last year, and there were 4 other players that had 100 tackles on this team, 3 of which return. Weston Johnson's the only player that doesn't. But that's an inordinate amount of tackles for that many players on a team to be 100-plus. I don't necessarily know if that's a good thing or a bad thing.
Coughlin flush from the pocket, out of bounds at the 29. Good chase by the Cowboys. A little extra jawing going on after that. And Brian Hendricks, along with Mertens, the defensive right tackle, in on that stop. So So Boise State will punt. And Wyoming will get the ball back as the clock runs under 6 minutes to play.
This is the point in the game where regardless of what's going on, you want to be able to make sure that you finish the game out right. When you put your head on the pillow at the end of the night, regardless of the outcome, you know you gave it your all. As a football player, when I was on the field, that was imperative.
5.5 minutes to play. Wyoming back on the field when we come back.
College football on the CBS College Sports Network is being brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15%. Call GEICO at 1-800-947-AUTO or visit geico.com. And by Icy Hot. Goes on icy to dull the pain, then gets hot to relax it away.
Icy Hot will come in handy tonight. I'd say it's been a physical ball game, dominated, yes, offensively by Boise State. But these teams have been cracking one another all night long. Dax Crum, the senior from Phoenix, Arizona, checks in. Hand off. Pinkalongo, the freshman, number 20, with the carry. And the speedster gets up to around the 41-yard line. And Aaron, how about a look at the Coke Zero playbook of possibilities?
Well, this is one of the great things that Doug Martin could do is use his tremendous vision. He sets his blockers up perfectly. It looks like he's going to have the play, and Wyoming's got the tackles, but he just uses tremendous shiftiness to change the direction to get north and south, which is how he had such a big night tonight.
And you can explore the playbook of possibilities only at CokeZero.com.
It would never be possible in 100 years for me to make any of those cuts. It's hard to walk upstairs now on these knees.
105 yards tonight, two receptions along the way for 40 yards, 17 carries. Clock under 5 minutes. Nearly 30,000 fans in the stands tonight, and I'd say about half remain.
I did move that fast once when I was a kid, and somebody broke the pinata though.
From the handoff, Pinkalongo off the right side. Short, looks to be just short of the first down.
Dax Crum was the player that Carter Samuels beat out last year. Wyoming's getting into a situation now where Dave Christensen also wants to get some of his backups some opportunities to play. And two different feelings depending on which sideline you're on. When you're on Boise's side, you want to see the young players out there make plays, and you want to root your teammates on. And if you're Wyoming, you just want the clock to end.
It is fourth and short. And Kinkalongo is going to be driven back. I don't think, nope, they're going to mark it about a yard loss on that play. So Wyoming will turn it over on downs, and it's Boise State football.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me that Dave Christensen makes that call. In the Texas game last week, there were a couple opportunities that they went for it on fourth down as well when they could have well easily kicked the field goal and got 6 courtesy points. But he said, hey, as a football coach, I want to try and win the game. I don't want to just try and get points on the board. So even though you're down 44-6 with only 3 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter, he's not playing in the game. He wants to at least have some sort of success.
Boise State, their defense, 10 tackles a night for losses. I think right now what Boise State would like to do, if you're Chris Peterson, get out of town healthy or as healthy as you possibly can with a 44-6 lead.
Looks like that's what he's doing, is getting Joe Southwick, the young freshman, some snaps. This will be a great opportunity for this Wyoming team to go back and look at the film and be able to shake it off. They've obviously, Craig, had some tragedies over the last week with Ruben Narcisse and some of the other players that were involved in that car accident. But this is how teams get an identity. This is how they can build a rapport and kind of turn things around a little bit and have some rallying points. There's no quitting this team.
Well, they donned the yellow jerseys tonight. It's been a night for Ruben. The crowd responded in a very big way, and this town of Laramie has really rallied around this football team. Boise State on the ground, and it just shows you the depth of this program. They just keep bringing guys off the bench. Shamil Gary with yet another tackle. Terrific game tonight. And there's number 12, Brian Hendricks, the team captain on the defensive side, wearing Ruben's number tonight. He usually dons number 8, but they're going to switch around each and every game. Another player will wear that number in honor of Ruben Narcisse.
Yeah, when we asked him about Ruben, he got immediately emotional yesterday and had to shift gears, and we started talking about his roommate, Gabe Napton, number 52.
Off the left side. There's a seam, and Boise State, you can't tell those third and four teamers not to put the pedal down. They don't get on the field very often, and it's going to be first and goal to goal at the 5. Now they're going to call it the 10-yard line. Just at the 10-yard line.
You really can't. Now's going to be an opportunity. This is really a gut check as we see Purcell run off the field for this Wyoming defense. I mean, Boise's knocking on the door. There's under 2 minutes left. They're on the 10-yard line. At some point, pride kicks in, and even though these guys aren't necessarily the starters, they still have a lot of pride as we take a look there at Sobel and Krasinski.
That's how you do it, Devin Harris. You stand the man up, put the hat on the number. A clock at 1:30 to play here in the fourth. A loss of one.
Taking a look at some of the defensive players there, and Ryan Winterswijk tied for 5th all time with sacks, with the sack that he had tonight. Tell you what, he and the other defensive end, Shea McClellan, and all front four of Boise had a tremendous night tonight. And if there were one position that I think really, really shined, they didn't get a lot of accolades, and we may not even talk about it up here quite as much as we could have, but that defensive line was tremendous.
Touchdown, Broncos.
A lot of smiling, happy Boise players with some bright green jerseys, or bright white jerseys.
Now the extra point to come. This score will grab the attention of a lot of folks around the country. You put 50 on anybody.
Yeah, you and I were talking about that. 50 was a big, important number for him. 51-6 on the road. Quarterback has a huge game. Boise State doing all it needs to do to keep its national championship hopes alive.
.57 ticks left on the fourth quarter clock. Boise State commanding 51-6 advantage. Number 3 ranked team in the country. They are deep on the offense and defensive ends. Little bobble on the kick. Picked up at the 10 and knocked down at the 14-yard line.
Hearn on the return and bobbled it a little bit. The Wyoming's last chance from the 14-yard line to try and get anything going offensively. It's not going to get any easier for this Wyoming team. This is the second top 5 team that they played in back-to-back weekends.
They got their conference opener next week against Air Force.
Take a look at this, the first 50-point game this season. My guess is it won't be the last.
Dax Crum, you could hear him huffing and puffing to the sideline, knocked down 16-yard line. Smiles all around for Boise State. Big night for that young man. Kellen Moore has Heisman dreams.
Well, his Heisman and their national championship is going to be dependent on their game next week against Oregon State. That's a must-win game. If they could put a showing on an Oregon State team like they've done on Wyoming here tonight, that would go a long way maybe to changing some of those minds of the biased voters out there that don't know this team well enough to respect the type of football that they play.
Well, at one time, Boise State was known as a Cinderella. They are a powerhouse in college football, and they put 51 on the board on the road tonight against the Cowboys of Wyoming. Boise State, 27 straight regular season win.
There's a reason for it, Craig. I mean, their offensive and defensive lines are tremendous. The speed at the skill position, having a true quarterback, and like we've talked about all game, depth. Boise's not only good, they're a deep team.
And we asked the coaches and players, how do you recruit to Boise, Idaho? Well, first, it's not a bad town if you've been there. And second of all, you have to go after the right kid. And I think what that kid is hard-nosed. Football is number one, along with, of course, what you do in the classroom. But Boise State on the right track with the big 51-6 win. Let's go downstairs.
Thanks, guys. Offense so effective tonight on the ground, in the air. Kellen Moore really seemed to read the defense, though. Well, is that one of the reasons you guys are so successful tonight?
Well, our quarterback always needs to play well for us to do what we want to do. And he had a pretty solid night as far as we could see from the sideline.
Well, then I have to ask you next question. Should this garner some more Heisman talk?
Yeah, I don't know about any of that. We're just trying to take one game at a time and, get better each week.
Yeah, get better each week. Oregon State on the horizon. How do you prepare for them?
Yeah, that'll be a tough task without question. And we'll go back tomorrow and make a new plan.
Altogether, you have to walk away feeling good, though, 51 points.
Yeah, we feel good. Guys played hard. You know, we have a lot of respect for Wyoming, and I think our team does too. And that's why we came out and played very hard. They're creative. They got some guys that play extremely well, and I'm just pleased with how hard our guys played.
Thanks so much, Coach. Craig, of course, Virginia Tech did them no favors losing to James Madison last week. We will look to prove themselves again next week against the Beavers.
All right. Thank you, Brooke. And the high fives all around for Boise State fans in Laramie tonight. The Broncos 51, Wyoming 6 for Aaron Taylor, Brooke Olsendam, and our entire CBS College Sports Network crew. Craig Bullerjack saying so long tonight. For scores and highlights, features, and more, go to CBSCollegeSports.com. This has been a presentation of the CBS College Sports Network. 51-6, Boise State in a runaway. Stay tuned for Inside College Football Extra, coming up after the break.